So you have a fabric which is cut and sewn into the lined women's trousers, and the wool yarn was formed in Canada. Elastomeric yarn was formed in Korea. So and the composition is a wool 96% and 4% spandex fabric. So notice that first of all, notice the origin. So you have wool yarn is Canada. So that's a NAFTA country. Then you have elastomeric yarn. It's the stuff that makes things stretch. Elastomeric is Korea. You have 96% versus 4%. And it was woven in the United States. The visible lining fabric was woven in Korea and classified under subheading. So there is a visible lining fabric component, right? So elastomeric yarn plus visible lining fabric. All right, so a visible lining fabric component is also in Korea. And it is classified under 55-12-19. So then you have trousers, which are women's trousers, imported to the United States from Mexico. Which of the following statements are true based on the requirements? So first of all, notice that the final fabric making, final garment making process takes place in Mexico. And it takes place from the components from another NAFTA country and from non-NAFTA state, right? So the first, so we have various questions, right? And if we briefly skim through them, we see NAFTA in the answer choice, pattern. And the question is does it qualify for NAFTA? Or does it not qualify for NAFTA, and the reason why, pretty much. So the first thing, of course, to do is to find out the classification for the HTS-US number for the women's trousers. Because without this, once you figure out the classification for women's trousers, you go to the general note 12T chapter rule for that particular classification, and you figure out the requirement. All right. So what we need to do is we need to find out how those women's trousers are qualified. So this question is a combination question. It's a classification question on one end, and the trade agreement, in this case NAFTA question, on the other. So first step is to find out the classification. So if, let's say you sit on the customs broker exam and you're trying to figure out the classification, and you have no clue where to start, the first starting point I would recommend would be the alphabetical index. Alright? So we have alphabetical index at the end of the harmonized tariff schedule of the United States. And we're looking for trousers. So we just going to go and briefly scroll through, or if you are on a customs broker exam, you flip through to the portion that deals with trousers, right? So you go to T, because the alphabetical index is in alphabetical order. And you find out that phrase for trousers. All right, so we know, so here it is, trousers. And we know that trousers for women or girls are available under the headings, or the subheadings in this case, 6204, 61 through 69. At this point, you may need to go further to find out the whole HTS number, but I don't think it would be wise if you are constrained by time, if you're under the time pressure, to do that, because this particular HTS number that you obtained from the alphabetical index may be sufficient starting point. So the next step is to go to the chapter note 12 T, which deals with the NAFTA provisions. So we go to the general, I'm sorry, it's a general note, not chapter note 12 T, and we're going to chapter 62. All right, so we are in rules in a section that deals with the rules for chapter 62. So the next thing is to find out the rule that would qualify this particular tariff provision. So we scroll through. I think I overdid it. And we're looking for the 6204-61. All right, so here it is, 6204-61, 6204-69. So notice, this information alone that you obtained from the alphabetical index is sufficient for us to know that paragraph 28 for the chapter 62 is applicable. So the next thing what we do is we read it, right? So before we even read that, take a look that there is no visible lining fabric requirement here, right? So that's pretty good, right? Because visible lining requirement under rule 1 that we just saw in the snippet of the outline is not applicable here. So it may give you a briefer because you are able to you do not need to have that extra step that you need, that you would have to apply otherwise. So okay, so let's see what it says. A change to subheadings 6204 from 6201 through 69, so that's us, except from headings 5106 through 5113, and so we have all those exceptions, right? Okay, so now we're kind of stuck here, because first thing we need to do is we need to figure out change from what, all right? Change, of course, is from the component, right? But what component? We know we have visible lining fabric component, which is 5512.19, and 5512.19 is an exception over here. So for us, this is, so if visible lining fabric is involved, we may be in trouble, because this exception is listed in that rule in the paragraph 28 rule. So we need to figure out, when we do the tariff shifting, we need to figure out what exactly we are doing tariff shifting analysis based on. And we know that we have elastomeric yarn, and we know that we have wool yarn, right? So first thing we need to do is to figure out whether or not this visible lining fabric part is is something that we need to be concerned with. So obviously paragraph 28 does not give us the whole answer, does not give us the whole picture. So we must look elsewhere. And that elsewhere part is located in another portion of the HTS of the general note 12T for the chapter 22, and it is found in chapter rule number 3. So let's see what chapter rule number 3 says. And generally, if chapter rule number 3 is, remember I mentioned that a lot of stuff are portable, a lot of knowledge is portable. So same thing is here. A lot of concepts that are derived in that are stated in rule 3, they are applicable all throughout. So it says the following: for the purposes of determining the origin of the good, the rule applicable to that good shall only apply to component that determines the tariff classification of the good, and as such component must satisfy tariff change requirements set out in the rule for that good. If the rule requires the good must also satisfy visible lining fabric requirement, but we know that visible lining fabric requirement is not part of the rule. So the buzzword here is we need to figure out the component that determines the tariff classification of the good. Is visible lining fabric a component that determines tariff classification of the good, irrespective of if it is provided in the paragraph? Well, no, it's not. Well, for that, unfortunately, we have to go to the HTS US tables and figure out for ourselves. So we have to pull up the HTS US. So we are going to the HTS US book. We are going to harmonize tariff schedule, and we type in that number right in there. 6204. 61. All right, great. So 62 or 461 is for stuff that are made out of wool or fine animal hair. So wool, in this case wool yarn from Canada, is the component that determines the schedule. So let's go a little bit farther and check if elastomeric yarn requirement, because if you have elastomeric yarn here, that it is a part of the formula. But if it is not, then we may do fine without it. So let's go back to the So we know it's a woven fabric, and we know we have lined women's trousers. All right, so going back to the HTS US, we know it's not recreational performance outwear, and we stick at the same line, so it must be other. Trousers, breeches containing elastomeric fiber, water-resistant belt loops of weighting more than 6 kilograms per dozen. Well, we do not know that. Customs examiners are not giving that information, so we move on. Then we have other, we have trousers and breeches, and we have women's. So apparently, the classification number for the women's trousers would be 6204. 61, 80, 10. So that looks like the classification based on the facts provided. Notice that examiners did not provide in the fact pattern this particular numbers. So we assume that those numbers are not provided because examiners just decided to omit it. And probably the reason they decided to omit it is because they implied this particular HTS US number. All right, so next thing we do, so we know, now we know the HTS US number. Now, And we know that wool component is the only component that determines not the visible lining fabric component, but the wool component. And we know that wool itself, the wool itself as a material is classified outside of chapter 6204. If we take a look at the section notes, we can see that the wool is likely to be classified somewhere in chapter 51. Because we're talking about yarn, right, at the yarn stage. So in Canada, it was chapter 51, and it made its shift to chapter 6204, heading to be exact, sometime down in Mexico. All right, so because of that, let's go back to the rule. So now we can go back to that paragraph 28 rule, and we can see that a change to subheadings in question, right? Subheading in question from any other chapter. In our case, it was chapter, I believe, 51, right? 51 is good enough, right? But look at the second part. Provided that the good is both cut and sewn or otherwise assembled in the territory of one or more NAFTA parties. And we know that the trousers in our example, they were cut and sewn in Mexico, which is a NAFTA member. So that means that those trousers under the paragraph 28 comply with the tariff shifting requirements. So they are qualified for NAFTA under the general note 12T. Okay, so with that information, now we are ready to jump into the analysis of the answer choices. So number A says, the elastomeric yarn from Korea disqualifies these trousers from NAFTA. We know that's not true because elastomeric yarn is not part of the equation. The Korean visible, because it doesn't give essential character, Korean visible lining fabric does not disqualify these trousers from Korean visible lining fabric does not disqualify these trousers from NAFTA. So that's we're looking for the true statement, of course. So we saw that the Korean that for the visible lining fabric, which was provided under rule 1, there was no requirement under the paragraph 28. There is no, like, see in 27 there is a requirement. Here there is no such requirement, right? On top of that, we know that visible lining fabric, after we saw the classification, is not part of the HTS-US finding. So that's also a criteria. So visible lining fabric is not a game changer here in this case, if you will. Therefore, this one is true. It's a true statement because visible lining fabric, it is not a game changer. It is not part of the equation, and therefore it does not disqualify trousers from the preferential trade agreement. So B is correct. Going to C, Korean visible lining fabric disqualifies these trousers from NAFTA. Notice how those questions are phrased. Remember that duality concept we talked numerous times before, where you have B and C that are direct opposites of each other. Whenever you see that type of propositions, you have to understand that those and those can be thrown away because it is either this or this that will be correct. Unless, of course, they are not responsive to the call of the question. But here they are responsive to the call of the question. And we know that visible lining fabric does not disqualify, making C also incorrect answer choice. D, the component that determines the classification of the trouser is classified in 55, 12, 19. No, the component that determines the classification of the trousers is classified somewhere in chapter 51 because it is wool yarn that is the component, wool fabric that is the component that determines classification of the trousers. these trousers do not qualify for NAFTA because they do not make the necessary tariff shift. And we saw that they do make the necessary tariff shift from chapter 51 to HTS US 6204-61A8010. Therefore, E is also incorrect. So based on this, we can pick B as a correct answer choice.